Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a second order differential equations problem. The function that we're given is y double prime minus 7y prime plus 10y equals 0. And as with any second order differential equations problem, the formula that we're going to be using is y of x equals c sub 1 e to the r sub 1x plus c sub 2 e to the r sub 2x. And the way that we're going to use this formula, our answer will still contain c sub 1 and c sub 2. What we're looking to solve for is r sub 1 and r sub 2. So we want to replace those with actual values from our problem. And the way that we do that is by transforming our original equation here into something that we can factor. So what we do is we replace the y's with r's. And when we have just y on its own here, we're actually going to treat it as 1. And then y prime we'll treat as r, y double prime we'll treat as r squared, which on the one hand is a little confusing. If it's tough for you to remember, I think the easiest trick is notice that with the y here, you have no little prime mark, right? It's just original y, so there's zero little dashes by it, right? Which is a ridiculous way to remember it, but you've got zero dashes. Y to the zero is one, so that becomes a one. Here we have one dash, so y to the one is just y, which we replace with r. Here we have two dashes, y to the two is y squared, we replace with r, we get r squared. So basically, you're just kind of counting the number of dashes, and y double prime gets replaced with r squared, y prime gets replaced with r, and y gets replaced with 1. So we make each of those replacements, and then we factor our function. In this case, the factoring is really easy. We end up with r minus 5 times r minus 2, and when we solve for r, we get two solutions. One is 5 and one is 2. You're always going to get two solutions when you do a second order differential equations problem, and you're going to plug one in for R1 and the other in for R2. So our final answer, remember we said we were going to leave C1 and C2, but we end up replacing R sub 1 and R sub 2 with the two solutions that we just found. So we end up with C sub 1 e to the 5x plus C sub 2 e to the 2x. And that's our final answer. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!